Hey, good morning and welcome to Patriot Radio News Hour. I'm Eric Cederstrom, CEO, shipping clerk, and janitor extraordinaire, and we are live from the Hole in the Ceiling studios in beautiful, vacant Deer Valley, Arizona on this third day of October. Is that right? Fourth day of October. I haven't reset my watch yet, so I didn't wear it all weekend. And, gosh, now I got to start all over again. Okay, let me see if I can catch up. Good morning. Welcome, Patriot Radio News Hour. I'm lost. Anyway, we're live from the Hole in the Ceiling studios on this October 4th, 2010, the year of our Lord. And this show is brought to you by us, the Patriot Trading Group. We handle gold and silver, and we ship it out to you, and you put it away. Why? Because you still can. Call us, 1-800-951-0592. With everything we're watching coming down the pipe here, ladies and gentlemen, the day may be rapidly approaching where you will not be able to do that. This show reverberates around the world at allamericangold.com. Allamericangold.com, updated daily by Heidi, the web babe, with news to comfort the disturbed and disturb the comfortable. Joined on this Monday morning, that's the heat has broken a little. It was only 84 degrees when I left my house at 7:20 this morning. I'm joined this morning with, a guy, speaking of hot, Joe's hot. The Double J, Jolton Joe Jaquin. Good morning. How are you doing?
Oh, God, I'm doing great. The weather is actually starting to get a little nicer.
Yeah, it's only going to be 137 out here today.
Playing golf in 160 degrees just isn't any fun.
Well, the good news is your score matches the temperature.
Yeah. We have a restaurant here in town that gives you whatever the temperature is. That's what they take off your bill. And I think it's about putting them out of business. So they would need the temperature
really?
To go down.
Whatever the temperature is, what I don't get it.
Oh, if it's like 170, they'll take $1.70.
Oh, $1.70. I gotcha. So, how was your weekend?
Uneventful.
Get caught up on some rest.
We did the usual basketball, followed by some more basketball.
All our weathermen used to be ex-financial planners.
God, they are terrible.
They just suck. All five-day forecasts, no matter when you look at them, life is great. Oh, yeah, a week ago Sunday, all 5 days. By last week, we were out of the heat. Everything was going to be great. Still 100 zillion degrees, man.
Every
five-day forecast has the heat breaking.
They are like the Federal Reserve guy. The economy's going to recover just
5 days.
Give it five more days. And then 5 days later, give it another 5 days.
Last Thursday they had it like, it's going to be 88 degrees. Close. 109. They got it really close. Supposed to be cloudy yesterday. Look at me. I'm just sunburnt everywhere.
There wasn't a cloud in sight. Well, I guess if you count the wind that kicked up and the dirt.
This is just the time of year. I don't usually talk this much about the weather, but. Enough. All right, it's October.
We give up. We surrender.
I surrender. This is when you wake up, when you move out here, if you really want to know what it's like, and people come out and they live out here for a year or two, and the phone rings one night, and they go, "How's the weather?" And they go, "Oh, it's great. It's raining."
Rain?
People are like, what?
Rain is a huge event.
What? Yeah, when it rains, people
kids are outside running around. They just think it's the greatest thing ever.
Oh, yeah, rain, man. It's we just don't see it that much. So, but, that's how you know you're in Arizona, when you tell people the weather's beautiful, it's raining. Now is just the time of year where you're just reading, it's going to end one of these days. It used to be the first real cold night growing up out here for you people that have just lived here for a year or two. It used to be within 72 hours either way of Halloween. You could almost catch it. Now, like last year, it was still warm at Thanksgiving. So the global warming thing's working really good. Our palm tree business in Denver has taken off. Oh, no, we're doing good up there. The palm trees grow right next to the pine trees now. Of course, Al Gore, he's our head salesman. He does a good job. So anyway, 1-800-951-0592 is our business line. I set the over-under for the weekend at 7 for bank closures. Way off.
Yes, you were. I was a little better. I think I came in at 5.
Came in at 5. Yeah, they just don't want to work. Right? Obviously, we already know they need to shut down 700 banks right now.
Well, and I think it's something like almost 200 banks that got TARP money that have now for two straight quarters, which, by the way, that's 6 months, haven't made a single interest payment that they're supposed to make on the money we lent them.
That's the new no-interest loan.
You would think that maybe we should shut those banks. Well, we didn't quite get around to that this weekend.
The new no-interest loan is they just have no interest in paying them. So regulators shut down only two small banks in Florida and Washington State Friday, now lifting the number to 129 U.S. bank closures. They say failures. The number's much bigger than that. There are so many insolvent financial institutions out there. But bank failures this year as loan defaults have mounted and the economic distress has lingered. The FDIC took over Wakulla Bank, based in Crawfordville, Florida, with $424.1 million in loans and only $386 million in deposits.
So $420-some-odd million now constitutes a small bank.
Yes, that's a small bank. Well, this one's really small. The Shoreline Bank in Shoreline, Washington. Never heard of Shoreline,
never
Washington.
Never been to Shoreline.
They only had $104.2 million in loans and $100.2 million in deposits. The 129 closures now nationwide exceeds that of 2009. A brisk year for shutdowns with 140. By this time last year, regulators had only closed 98 banks. Oh, there we go. So I don't know. It's Monday. How about those Cardinals? Do they stink or what? So,
well, you know what? Let's face it. How long could it last, really? I mean, we went 9-7 twice. Made it to a Super Bowl. I mean, we got carried away.
It was pretty good, wasn't it? So
it's all over. ASU stinks.
Yeah, poor ASU.
They're
actually,
fun
they're
to watch.
Good. They
they're
just can't
fun
win.
To watch. They just can't win it.
You're right. Patriot Radio News Hour will return on Monday with more sports. Listening to the blind leading the stupid, the Patriot Radio News Hour here every day, Monday through Friday, wherever you might be in this wide world of sports listening. Thanks for taking the time. I mean, you can hear us on various AM stations around the nation and some mostly internet. You're in little nooks and crannies and people all over the world. Thank you for taking times out of your busy schedule. I went to they had a home show here over the weekend, which I try to stay in touch with the commoners, get out there and see what's going on, see how the housing market's doing. They canceled these. I mean, I think in 08, they didn't even bother to have them. But, well, the vendors are out there. You got about.
So this is like the.
It's where everybody sets up. You have the Coliseum.
Okay, like barbecue grill.
Yeah, tile guys.
Tile wood guys.
Remodeler guys.
Right.
Solar guys everywhere. Probably out of the total vendors, which go a long way. I mean, you sit there, the kitchen, palapas. Bricks, concrete, drywall, carpet, granite, wood, goes on and on. Out of that, I would have to say 4 out of every 10 displayers was a solar company. So it's overbilled as well, and they're pulling all the
funding.
They're pulling all
the rebates,
so yeah. It won't work. The states can't afford to pay your power bill, ladies and gentlemen. Give me a break. So, but I have to tell you that being made in America is becoming quite vogue. And people are starting to pay attention. Wall Street Journal front page is Americans now sour on trade. The American public, already skeptical of free trade, is becoming increasingly hostile to it. And I can tell you that anything that is made in America, they make a big deal out of now. And people will pay the extra money, I believe.
So you're sitting there saying people are now starting to want it back.
They want it back. This is exactly what's happened. Across the country, politicians are responding accordingly to the clouding prospects for congressional approval of pending free trade pacts now with South Korea and Colombia. It is also prompting concerns about, like, we don't have free trade with Colombia. More cocaine coming in here. Tax-free cocaine.
I was just going to say.
If you looked at our
Colombia thinks it's free trade.
Our trade deficit with Colombia, that was reported, we'd all be bankrupt. But, yes, the U.S. businesses now are reliant on the rest of the world for growth. In the latest Wall Street Journal NBC News poll, More than half of those surveyed, 53%, said free trade agreements have hurt the United States. That's up 46% from just 3 years ago, and only 32% when they passed them in 1999. If you remember all this.
Give it another couple of years. I think that number is going to be about 89%.
Even Americans most likely to be winners from trade, upper income, well-educated professionals whose jobs are less likely to go overseas and whose industries are often buoyed by demand from international markets, are increasingly skeptical. Yeah, how many financial jobs did Meredith Whitney say they were who were going to lose?
50,000 to 80,000.
Just before Christmas.
For the fourth quarter.
Fourth quarter of this year.
When they do fourth quarter earnings, the trading volumes have been so porous, the lack of volume on Wall Street is going to hurt all the banks' earnings, and how they're going to make it sound better, like they always do, is, well, we missed earnings, but here's the good news. We just laid off 10,000 more people. They clap, stock goes up.
Yep. Yeah, well, that's not really working real good anymore. So the important change now is that very well-educated and upper-income people, yes, you know, the stockbrokers, the financial planners that moved all your money. Now they're talking this morning on Bubble Vision on CNBC. I was watching, and they had the parade. Now the commercials are all running about how emerging markets are much better to invest in again than developed countries. I mean, they're really trying to push this really hard. Now, out here in the Arizona Republic, the last two weekends of the business section 2 weeks ago was real estate investment trusts. Yes, come on in for the big win, ladies and gentlemen. This is how bad it is.
They're really doing well.
Then Sunday this week was all the great buys from the inner city commercial that everybody's looking at. Yes, how you can come in here and buy these entire corners and put high rises on them in town. Nobody wants to invest out of town anymore because, well, they don't believe we're going to have growth. But all the empty lots that are in town, that's where you want to put your money.
How long? You've lived here for what?
Ever,
right?
Since 1967, off and on.
Trying to revitalize downtown with these skyscrapers and these shopping centers and all of this stuff. Ever since I moved to Phoenix 16 years ago.
Yeah, they've been trying to do it. So, well, it was really bad, though. You got to remember. So it was really bad down there. So they just keep moving the hookers farther and farther.
They
I don't know where they're at now. Everybody knew the hookers were on Van Buren.
I
don't know where they are anymore. They moved them. But I'm sure they're out there somewhere.
You're going to get relocated.
I guess that's how they upgraded. I don't know.
They obviously foreclosed on their corner.
Yeah. So anyway. But I find it interesting because when I went to the home show, and it was Made in America, they would stand there going, "This is Made in America. This is Made in America." But everybody's all hucksters. You know, you walk by and they're like, "Hey, kid, come here. You want to buy a kitchen?" I go, "A kitchen?" Eric, I frequently hear you talking about nothing is Ms. Email manufactured in the United States anymore. And I echo your sentiments until today. I, too, live on a dirt road, just like as I do as well. Being fed up with my overly capitalistic neighbor who wants to charge me $25 to fix the road every time it rains, I called up Dr. Power Equipment and ordered a power grader. At first, I thought I'd called the wrong number because the man on the other end of the phone assured me the product was made in Vermont. What's more, he spoke perfect English. I could even hear people in the background speaking English as well. Wow.
Wow.
I asked him, "Where is your call center located?" Expect to hear Canada or some offshore island country I'd never heard of.